So I kind of always knew I was going to be working in ministry in some way. Ever since I could remember, that was what I wanted to do, but never as a pastor, never. I never even thought I was going to go to seminary. I thought I was just going to get a job that helped someone. But then I did my volunteer year in Chicago through mission year, and I was just blown away by God's promises and how faithful He was, and how much joy I found, and how much joy I found in working with other people in His name. So basically, the way I thought about it was always I was a neighbor to those who wanted to be a neighbor to me, and I was a neighbor to those who loved me in return, and I never seeked out my actual neighbors who probably didn't even want to be my neighbor, or who I had to wear down with presence and patience and love so that they would want to be my neighbor. And with other people, it was easy. All I had to do was approach them, and I was received. So there's more, I think, that the Bible includes when it's talking about being a good neighbor than we understand in our world today. And especially, I can pick up a cell phone and call someone anywhere in the world, but I can't talk to the person who lives down three buildings down from me, or even in the next apartment over. I'm an immigrant, so I've been living cross-culturally here in the U.S. my whole life, almost my whole life. And that has taught me a lot about continuing the fight, continuing to come back day after day, and learning more about other cultures and other people, and how to be with other people who are different than me. And the other way I would definitely say was through my year of service in mission year, when we had to be with people who were completely different than us, people who didn't know my story, and people who I didn't know their story and could never understand fully their neighborhood story. And it's just that everyday presence, everyday reminder, it's really humbling. And I believe that humility and humbling yourself before God and before the service is always the way to go, because God always has more and more, and He's gonna keep on teaching you more, and He's gonna move in the hearts of other people and in your heart to continue spreading His good works. And it's definitely in that conflict, zone of conflict, that you grow. And somebody once told me that to do something you've never achieved before, you have to do something you've never done before. So it's hard, but it's important, and it's worth it.